रिकॉर्डिंग इज इन प्रोग्रेस।
Ma'am, can we start, ma'am?
Yes, yes.
One minute, ma'am. Madam has joined.
Hello?
Subhashini. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Our speaker has joined the session.
Okay, yes. All the speakers. I'm sorry.
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, good morning.
How are you, ma'am?
Fine, ma'am. Nice to see you, ma'am.
Thank you, thank you.
Can you see me?
Subhashini?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Students have they have come assembled.
Yes, ma'am. They have assembled. Okay. Just a second, ma'am.
Yeah. Actually, we are bringing down the students to the hall, ma'am.
Okay, okay, ma.
Okay. So that everyone will glance the big screen.
Oh, that will be nice.
Game 5. Yeah, yes, ma'am.
So you have wonderfully organized.
Pardon, ma'am?
You have wonderfully organized.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Maybe sometime later you come, you visit our campus too, ma'am.
Sure, sure, definitely. It's a pleasure.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, I'll ask the comparing girls to start.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
I think Vice Chairman also is here. Sir is also here, ma'am.
Okay. So, I mean, you will begin or shall I begin?
The students will start with, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
We'll start with a prayer song too.
Right, right, right.
They'll do the comparing, ma'am. They'll do the comparing. I have asked them to start.
Yeah, okay. You start with this question.
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
He's our vice chairman, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am. Nice to have you here, ma'am.
Sir, it's actually, you have given me a wonderful opportunity. I have to thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I look forward to hearing you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Ma'am, Subhashini, ma'am, we'll start, ma'am.
Subhashini?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I was coordinating with the comparing girls, ma'am.
Yeah,
they'll start shortly. They'll start.
Yeah.
PowerPoint presentation. Mandra, ma'am.
Subhash, ma'am, we'll start, ma'am.
Sure, sir.
Good morning, everyone. I would like to welcome our honorable chief guest, vice chairman, madam principal, staff, and my dear friends. I quote, "The English language is nobody's special property. It is the property of the imagination. It is the property of the language itself." I unquote. Today, we have gathered here for innovation in English learning and its significance in National Education Policy 2020. Let us begin the day by paying tribute to our mother tongue. Now, I request everyone to raise for Samaj Divisor.
நீராடும் கடலுத்த நில மடந்தை கெடிலொழுகும் சீராடும் மதனமென திகழ் பரத கண்டனிடும் அதில் சிறந்த திராவிடன் திருநாடும் முதலும் தலித்தனும் திலகமுமே அத்திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இன்பமுட எத்திசையும் புகழ் மணக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழனங்கே சீரிழவை திரட்டி என்று செயல் மறந்து பார்த்ததுமே
Now I request D. Shweta from the Department of BCom ANS to deliver the welcome address.
Good morning to one and all present here. Do it now, sometimes later, becomes never. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to this innovation in English learning and its significance with National Education Policy 2020 program organized by our department, Electronics and Communication Science, Prince Sri Venkateshwara Arts and Science College, Gaurivakam, Chennai. Learning is a treasure. Learning leads to step up in our lives. A great warm welcome to our today's guest of honor, Dr. R. Revathi, who is a dean of the most renowned institution, Sri Krishnaswamy College for Women, Annanagar, Chennai. We heartily welcome you, ma'am. I extend my heartfelt thanks to our chairman, sir, in absentia, Dr. K. Vasudevan, Prince Group of Institution, with whose guidance, blessings, and support we organize this program. We thank you, sir. I extend my warm welcome to our energetic, inspiring, and dynamic Vice Chairman, sir, Engineer V. Prasanna Venkatesh, Prince Group of Institution, whose ideas of student centricity have assured in several development of learning English skills among students. We heartily welcome you, sir. I welcome our ever-charming principal madam, Dr. Uma Bhaskar, who's always guiding and motivational force for us. We heartily welcome you, ma'am. I extend my warm welcome to all heads of the department, all our Prince family members and my friends who have joined here. We also thank for your overwhelming interest towards innovation in English learning program. I hope that all of you will have an interesting and useful session today. I once again extend a warm welcome to everyone present here. Thank you.
Thank you, Shweta. It is said that, and I quote, "Great leaders don't set out to be a leader. They set out to make a difference. It is never about the role, but always about the goal." I unquote. This quote perfectly reflects the traits and beliefs of our vice chairman. Now I request our honorable vice chairman to address the gathering.
A very good morning to everybody here, and very good morning to our chief guest, Dr. R. Revathi, and all our students, all our coordinators as well. It's a very beautiful day today. Hopefully, we are looking forward to our rains as well in the next few days. Before that, it's a sunny day today. So let's start our day for the beautiful seminar which is going to be conducted by Dr. R. Revati, our chief guest. She's a very multi-talented, multifaceted person. She currently holds the position of Dean in Sri Krishna Swami College for Women. A pleasure to have you here. And on behalf of Prince Sri Venkateshwara Arts and Science College's Institution Innovation Council, which we started very recently, ma'am, and along with the English Literary Association of Prince Sri Venkateshwara Arts and Science College, we're all here for the beautiful day, for the beautiful seminar on innovation in English learning and its significance in the National Education Policy 2020. The National Education Policy is again something a lot of people dream of, and we are looking at its implementation and see the positives and negatives. And it is such a beautiful thing to actually have a very eminent speaker speak about the significance of the English language in that aspect. And this entire seminar is not possible without the support and the organization, organizing capacities of our IIC coordinators, the president, Dr. K. Subhashini, a lot of other coordinators, Punita madam, Soumya madam, and of course, the arrow behind everything is our honorable principal, Dr. Uma Bhaskar. Without her, I'm sure that the Institution Innovation Council wouldn't have taken shape. So I'm glad to have you all here. I'm really looking forward to the wonderful session by Dr. R. Devi. Thank you very much. Thank you to the students as well for being here.
Thank you, sir. Madam Visharia said a nice quote: "A great principal builds character, inspires dreams, encourages creativity, builds confidence, instills a lot of learning, touches our hearts, and changes our lives forever." I unquote. This is very true of our beloved principal. I request Madam Principal to address the gathering.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, everybody. Hearty welcome to our research person, Dr. Revati ma'am. And it was nice speaking to you. I should say the moment I called you and you accepted immediately our invite. Really great, ma'am. Once your busy schedule, you're here. I should refer that the topic like innovation in English learning and its significance in NEB 2020. I should refer that it has gone to the right guest, right resource person, right audience at the right time now. Because all of us know that communication is very important, and the role of communication right now, it plays a vital role in each and every student's life. And I think it's going to be great to listen to this seminar organized by the Institutions Innovation Council and also the English Literary Association of our college. And my hearty wishes to all, everyone who had organized this very good, great program. And having a resource person like Revati ma'am, I think the children will be enriched with the knowledge and also be enlightened after this session, I think. And they should get motivated like anything, ma'am. I know you will do it. And then a great success to all students who are attending this program. Kindly pass on this message. Do not carry, do not hold within you. Let the light of enrichment in English language also spread along to all students, whoever is with you. So thank you very much for organizing such program. And also my hearty welcome and wishes to Revati ma'am once again. Let us wait and are waiting for your visit here to our campus to address our children in person, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. Next, I call upon S. Vaishnavi from the Department of Electronic and Computer Science to brief about IIC.
A pleasant morning to everybody. I am S. Vaishnavi of First DPS. I'm here to talk about IIC, Institution Innovation Council, an initiative of MHRD, Government of India, was established in our college. This academic year to systematically foster the culture of innovation amongst the students' community. The objective of IIC is to prepare the students with skills like critical thinking, pattern analysis, design thinking, innovative thought process, and entrepreneurial mindset. IIC in Prince Sri Venkateshwara Arts and Science College organizes periodic workshops, seminars, interactions with investors, professionals and create a mentor pool for student innovation. It also organizes idea competitions, hackathons, mini challenges with involvement of industries nearby. The major purpose of IIC is to create a vibrant local innovation ecosystem. The IIC theme of our college is III: Imagine, Innovate, Invent. Let's gear up with the innovative ideas and implement it in our learning process. Thank you.
Thank you, Vaishnavi. Next, I call upon A. Yogalakshmi from the Department of English to brief about English Literary Association.
A pleasant morning to everyone. On behalf of English Literary Club, I would like to mention our endeavors and achievements. Our college aims at encouraging student participation through various club activities, thereby achieving holistic development of the students. Language skills of the student community is enriched through various activities of the club. I take pleasure in elaborating the mission and vision of English Literary Club. The club is established to facilitate the student participation through copious activities. The club motivates, encourages, and provides the students with numerous opportunities in various enterprises, which enhances the efficiency of students constantly. It encourages enthusiastic participation of the students in club activities by providing platform to exhibit, enhance their literary talents through performing extempore, debate, tongue twisters, and other speech activities. Various level competitions were held, namely interdepartmental, intradepartmental, and intercollegiate levels. I'm very much privileged to say that our college is an active participant of Chennai Literary Fest every year. The mission of our club is to develop the communicative skills of the students. Our club also focuses on demonstrating their literary talents and showcase them in the preferable competitions. It exalts the students' linguistic skills and helps them analyze the fine nuances of different facets of literature. In the year 2019, the club conducted various competitions at interdepartmental level, such as mime, essay writing, extempore, damsharats, tongue twisters, and debate. Students from various departments exhibited their talents through participation in all assorted fields. The winners were awarded with trophies and certificates at different levels. Chennai Literary Fest conducts workshops and seminars in collaboration with different colleges every year. Our club is an active participant every year. In the year 2019, our club conducted a workshop on challenges in English language teaching. It was an elevating session for students as well as staff and created a milestone. Our vision is to revise and restore the art of reading with passion, to give wings to our students' imagination, to create passion for literature and display their innovations, and develop their reading habit and engage them in creative writing. We have also planned some activities for the upcoming academic year as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Yogalakshmi. Now I invite Priyadarshika from the Department of Commerce to present a comprehensive note on the remarkable feats of our resource person.
Good morning to all. I am Priyadarshika of First BCom. I take the great privilege in introducing Dr. R. Revery, our guest of honor and speaker for today's occasion. She is a woman of virtue and simplicity, and she is a living inspiration to all of us. Dr. R. Revery finished her post-graduation and received a doctorate in English from the University of Madras. She started her career as a lecturer in English department of Valliammal College for Women in the year 1990. She joined as the assistant professor in Tirthangal Nadar College from 1998 to 2007. She became the principal of that college in the year 2007. She worked as the language trainer. Presently, she is working as a dean in Sri Krishna Swami College for Women, Chennai. She has been recognized as a guide for PhD scholars by the University of Madras and Emmett University. She has her footprints in publishing books and contributed many articles to journals. She also presented a paper in international and national conferences. She also presented a short story for children in the All India Radio. She is one of the members of NAAC committee, and also she organized the international seminar conducted in Bharati Women's College, and she is appointed as the external examiner for soft skills examination by various colleges. She has so I welcome our chief guest Dr. R. Revathi to share a valuable experience on today's topic. Thank you.
Thank you, Priyadarshika. Bill Owens says, and I quote, "True leadership lies in guiding others to success and ensuring that everyone is performing at their best, doing the work and doing it well." I unquote. I believe that there is no one else better suited for this quote other than our honorable resource person. Now I request our honorable resource person to address the gathering.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Respected
Good morning,
Vice,
ma'am.
Respected Vice Chairman, Sri Prasanna Venkatesh Vasudevan, Madam Principal, Dr. Uma Bhaskar, President of Institutions Innovation Council, Dr. Subhashini, Coordinator of English Literary Association, Mrs. Jeevalata, and all faculty coordinators and student coordinators of IAC. Once again, a very good morning. At the outset, I would like to thank the management, Madam Principal, and other coordinators for giving me a wonderful opportunity to address you all. And sir has already spoken about the NEP 2020, and Madam and others, they have spoken much about me, and I don't know whether I deserve all these things. Anyway, let me talk to you. Then you can decide. Now, today's topic is innovation in English learning and its significance in NEP 2020. Now, I'm going to take the second part in the beginning. That is the significance of NEP 2020. Okay, and then I'm going to talk about innovation in English learning. Let us see the PowerPoint now. Can you see the PowerPoint presentation? A few seconds, please.
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Anyway, I'll just give an introduction about the National Education Policy 2020. Actually, this policy is revised after 34 years. And you will find almost 27 salient features of NEP 2020. But today, I'm not going to talk about all the 27 salient features, but let us take just two or three vital points which are necessary, I mean, for the present day. I hope you can see. National Education Policy 2020 is the first education policy of the 21st century to meet the challenges of Indian and international education standards. As I said, it has been revised after 34 years. And now, the first and foremost thing
is I'm sorry, ma'am. We can't see your PPT, ma'am.
You can't see the PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Just a few seconds. 1 minute. Can you see it now? Excuse me. Can you see the PPT now?
No, ma'am. No.
No. Just a minute. Is it visible now?
It's clear, ma'am.
No? You are able to see?
We can see, yeah.
Yes. Have you seen the first two?
No.
Yes, this is the first one. Okay. Now, actually, that was introduced in the 21st century, first policy. Okay. After 34 years. Now we go to the third one. The important change, okay, that is actually it has come in the pattern, educational pattern. See, so far, we are actually, at present, even now, we have 10 plus 2 pattern, but according to NEP 2020, the pattern is 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. Okay, I'll just explain it. Preschool, 3 years, that happens usually. Then standard, first standard and second standard. So at the age of 5 years, a child will complete, first standard and second standard by the age of 5. Then preparatory, 3 years. Preparatory is nothing but elementary, which we call as elementary. Third, fourth and fifth. Okay. And then middle school, 6th, 7th, 8th, 3 years. That is also as usual. Then secondary, actually 4 years, 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th. Now the board examinations like 10th and 12th shall remain the same. And I can find out the students, they are actually terribly upset when I say the board examinations 10th and 12th remain the same. But don't worry, these two board examinations will not be which you have faced already. You are all undergoing degree course, so you must have faced the hurdles of 10th and 12th. Why I am saying is, it is not the board examinations which give you problem, but it is actually the stories which are unnecessarily attached to the 10th and 12th examinations. Actually, you students, youngsters, are bold enough to face any examination. But unfortunately, the parent community is not like that. The parents, they tend to get afraid of the board examinations. And we can't blame the parents also. Nowadays, it is actually their friends and relatives, they attach undue importance to the board examinations. You know what they call the board examinations? It is a crucial point. As though these two examinations are going to decide your future, entire future in your life. It is not like that. But their friends and relatives will actually tend to make them nervous. You will not be nervous, but your parents will be nervous. And in turn, what will happen? The parents will actually, they tend to frighten you. And some parents even go to the extent of blackmailing their children. If you are not going to this much of total, how am I going to face my friends? How am I going to face my relatives? So what that they are doing, they are actually putting pressure on you, and you people are pressurized, and in turn, you are facing all the tension. Naturally, you are not able to study properly. 50% you are able to study, 50% tension, the pressure, everything. Then how can you score good marks? Only a few who are able to manage, who remain strong in their life, they will be able to achieve. But others, so basically the problem is not yours. So you need not be afraid of 10th and 12th when this pattern is introduced. Okay, now shall we go to the next one? Why I'm saying you need not be afraid of 10th and 12th in this pattern, board examinations. We'll see the goal of NEP 2020. The goal is to introduce a holistic and multidisciplinary education. In other words, a student should excel in curriculum, extracurricular and co-curricular, coupled with 21st century skills. He should also possess environment education, value-based education, life skills, global citizenship education, and internships. Now, first, I'll start with the word holistic. What is holistic? Complete, total. He should excel in everything. It is not jack of all trades, master of none. It is not like that. But he should have, what are all the things, he should learn, that we will see. And multidisciplinary education, multidisciplinary referring to all disciplines like arts, humanities, and sciences, professional courses, occasional education, everything. In other words, a student should excel in curriculum, academics, then extracurricular. Extracurricular referring to like sports. Then co-curricular. Co-curricular is something add on to the curriculum. Plus, coupled with 21st century skills. See, I need not tell you what are 21st century skills. Okay. Already you are all good at, you are all tech savvy. I need not tell you what is 21st century skills. Now at present, everything like artificial intelligence, like data science, everything. You have to excel in all these things. And you should also know what is environment education. What about the environment? In what kind of environment we are in, we are living. And then value-based education. Value-based education is something really very, very good. Not very good, you need it. Values are nothing but qualities, good qualities, life skills. See, everything you have, if you don't have life skills, it is hopeless. Life skills is how you move with people, how you adjust with people. You should know how to behave, what to say. Everything is life skills. In this world, you have to cooperate a lot. You have to compromise a lot. So these are all life skills. And global citizenship education. Why global citizenship education? Because you are actually living in, not in India, but an interconnected world. Okay. And so you have to know, you have to deal with the global issues. So you need global citizenship education and internships. Internships are nothing but, going to like a companies, organizations for commerce students, and for English people, going to the publishing house, knowing about everything so that you get a practical exposure. Instead of only bookish knowledge, you get a practical exposure. So now you understand, this is what I mean by holistic education, multidisciplinary education. So multidisciplinary education will make you, coupled with environment education, value-based education, and life skills and knowledge about other countries, will definitely, you will be a holistic individual. Now we'll go to the next slide, please. Now, as I said, nearly 27 points, and we are not going to discuss all these things. And I have taken only three, which are relevant to our topic today. Okay, first one is early childhood care and education, ECCE. Foundation Literacy and Numeracy, FLN. multilingualism and the power of language. Now, early childhood care and education, this actually, children will be taken care. Now, you can argue even at the age of three, nowadays the children are going to school. It is, called play school. But actually, this is not done properly. Why? Because all the children are not going. Many people are not given such a kind of education. All these because of social issues, economic issues, political issues. There are many issues. So children at the age of three are not given proper care. Or all the children, only a few, maybe 20 to 25%, they are able to go to, a play school. And you must understand one thing. The people will say, before the age of six, 85% of the brain development occurs in children of six. So imagine, this age, 3 to 6 is very, very, it plays a crucial role. So in this age, in those 3 years, we cannot take it easily. We have to actually give them a lot. We have to provide them a lot so that they will develop. So what are all the things you can give them? You can make them, engage them in activities. Task-based activity. Asking them, you can teach them language also. Language, number, colors, shapes, and arts, make them play a drama, dance, everything. You can actually drawing and you can engage them in everything, okay? And life skills actually, at this age, you can actually, you have to tell them, if you bring your food, just share with your friend, okay? And if your friend is not feeling well, just ask her about it. And if your friend gives you something, say thank you. And if you want to ask something from your friend, say please. So all these things, if you actually, how moving with other children, cooperating with other children, you have to actually make them do. So all these things in those, actually, it starts at the age of three. Okay, in those 3 years, early childhood care and education, everything should be taken care of. Then only the children will have very good idea. So because at that time itself, cognitive development actually happens to occur. What do you mean by cognitive development? Okay, I'll explain it later, but now I'll give you just a hint. Okay, it is about thinking. It is about reasoning. Okay, understanding. I'll tell you again afterwards. Okay, and not only that, social and emotional and ethical development. What are all the things I said? They're all how to move with other kids, social development. Okay, and emotional, if a child cries, go and ask her or ask him if she has got any pain. All these things are emotional and ethical development. Now, we'll go to the next slide. According to NEP 2020, three language system. And you need not worry about it. Three languages, they are actually the students will be really, really benefited. For example, mother tongue. Now, I hope you all know that a child at the age of three, you know the vocabulary, you know her vocabulary or her or his vocabulary. It is actually 5,000 words. What do you mean by vocabulary? The knowledge of words. How many words a child will have? 5,000 words. Can you imagine? It is very difficult to imagine, but it is actually true, 5,000 words. And where does the child learn? The child learns from its mother, mainly from the mother, and probably from the father, their grandparents, the close relatives. Okay. Now, for example, her mother tongue is Tamil. Okay. Now, what happens? What the parents do? What do they do at the age of three, or sometimes even at the age of 2.5? They admit the student in a in a school where the medium of instruction is English. You are able to understand? 85% of the brain development occurs at this age. Now the child already knows 5,000 words in Tamil, and imagine all of a sudden, entering a school where English medium, the teachers speak English and everybody speaks English, how the child will suffer. Now you are able to understand the difficulty of the child. So what happens? The development, the cognitive development stops there. Quite a few number only they are able to succeed. Others, they find it very, very difficult. Okay, then that is why, according to NEP 2020, let them learn in their mother tongue. Okay, now for example, what is local language? Then another thing is local language. What is local language? Suppose you are a Malayali settled in Tamil Nadu. Okay, or you are from Mysore and Bangalore, and your language is Kannada, and you have settled in, your parents have settled in Chennai. And what will you do? Okay, that is your local language. So the school or the teachers, the school and the teachers and the government should all cooperate. And actually, they have to provide teachers who can deal with local language, and there should be the availability of textbooks also to teach the children. So now you are able to understand mother tongue, local language. So less percentage will be local language. Okay, but and then third one is foreign language. Well, which is foreign language? Naturally here, English. So let there be English. Okay, but let it not be a medium of instruction. Let the mother tongue be the medium of instruction, so that the children will learn their languages in a very, very beautiful manner. And in course of time, they will excel in foreign language. Okay, now we will see what are all the benefits if they actually go through the entire, education in mother tongue. We'll see the benefits now in the next slide. Benefits of mother tongue as medium of instruction. The child will be comfortable. I'm sorry, there is a spelling mistake. It is comfortable. He will feel at home. Comfortable meaning he will feel at home. Okay. Faster learning and retention. He will learn fast. And retention. Retention meaning it will be there. It will be always there in his brain. And parents' participation will be very high. Parents' participation. See, many parents who do not have, I'm sorry to say this, who do not have an iota of English knowledge, but they dream high. They want their children to study in English medium schools. See, you can't blame the parents also. We have not studied. At least let our children learn in English medium. That is their dream. But at that time, you cannot talk to the parents about the progress of the student, because they do not know anything about English medium. So their participation is naturally very less. And if it is in Tamil medium or if it is in mother tongue, the child attains self-confidence. And mother tongue provides a sense of belonging, identity. Okay. So, I need not be afraid of anyone. If I'm not comfortable, I can talk about it. This is my school. This is my home. I can talk about it. Okay. I can express myself. So these are all the benefits of mother tongue as medium of instruction. Now, advantages of multilingualism. What about the advantages of learning all the three languages? Cultural awareness. See, mother tongue, for example, if it is in Tamil, okay, then naturally you will know about everything about Tamil Nadu, cultural heritage of Tamil Nadu. Okay, then local language, any language tells about the culture, tradition of a state or a country. You come to know about everything. Naturally it will not come. You have to know about the heredity, all the tradition of the state or nation, sense of identity or belonging. You feel, I belong to this state and I'm happy about it. And I take pride in this. Then cognitive and creative abilities. As I said, again, the word cognitive is very important because it helps you to think, to write, to reason, to understand, to justify, okay, and creative abilities. You can create, not necessarily you have to write. You can create many things. So all those abilities, I mean, the language actually or multilingualism, it provides you all these things. Now, we'll go to the next slide. Now I'm going to come to the first part, innovation. See, innovation in English, actually, it is not something new. It is a continuing process. Learning is a process which can be pursued at any time. So as long as you learn, innovation will always be there. See, and it is a challenge for both the teacher and the student. See, in those days, when I was studying in school, and teachers have asked us, take the dictionary, find out three words, find out the meaning daily, write down. Okay, daily you do this. Okay, now what is the use of that? Okay, times have changed. See, when you actually find out five words, write the meaning, you will forget it. You are able to understand, you will forget it. You should know, because English is a contextual language, you should know how to use that word in a particular context. That only you should know. And actually, I mean, you have four skills also, LSRW. And how are you going to develop those skills? Listening, speaking, writing, okay, and reading. So how, I mean, what kind of innovation will help you to excel in all the four skills? That we have to do that. Okay, that is why I said it is a challenge for both the teacher and the student. So the teacher has to take care of that. It is I will not say it is a burden, it is a duty of the teacher. Now we'll go to the next slide. Now, how you can actually engage the students? That is what I'm going to talk about. See, one thing, let me tell you, you can say, we don't have time during the class hours. Definitely, you will not have time during the class hours. See, you have to complete the syllabus portions. I mean, that itself will take you a lot of time. It is what I'm suggesting you is after class hours. And you can also say that it is an affiliated college to University of Madras. Okay, right. But after class hours, okay, you can engage the students. It is actually going to help them a lot. Okay, and you can even say some students, they want to go immediately after the classroom. It is in your hands to attract them by doing all these things. So what are all these things? I will tell you, merely I'm not going to deal with this PowerPoint presentation. One by one, I'll deal with it. For example, it is actually all these are activities. Tasks, okay, play-based. So you need not worry about the noise. They will shout, they will make noise. But after the college hours, it is okay. Okay, right. Now, first of all, pronunciation. And many words you will find in English will not go by pronunciation, will not go by the spelling. You all know about it. Now, first of all, you just ask the students, what is the difference between, is there any difference in spelling between pronouns and pronunciation? What is the difference? Pronouns is pronounce, but pronunciation is pronunciation. So basic itself, you can start. Now, then you can ask them to talk, I mean, tell the words. The teacher has to tell the words and they have to actually spell the words. The teacher has to tell, for example, subtle. And what they will tell, I mean, some of them, they know how to spell the word like S-U-B-T-L-E. Okay. And others, they will come to know from others. And atom bomb. You say atom, not atom bomb, B-O-M-B, atom bomb. Okay. And pain bomb. This is B-O-M-B. That is, I mean, same sound, but this is B-A-L-M. Is it clear? The spelling is also different. For example, we don't say colonel, C-O-L-O-N-E-L. No, colonel. It is pronounced as colonel. And you don't say lieutenant. The spelling is actually L-I-E-U-T-E-N-A-N-T. So in this way, you can conduct pronunciation games and quizzes. You can conduct a lot. Then you must know there are words. English is not, only English words. There are many words. Many words are taken from other languages. From nearly 350 languages, words have been taken from other language and they are introduced in English. For example, the common words which you come across every day, entrepreneur. Commerce people will come across this entrepreneur. And the English literature students, genre, and then guru. Guru is actually a Sanskrit word from India. Okay, like that, Latin, French, Japanese, and even from Africa, many words are introduced. And especially in the field of law, many legal terms are borrowed from Latin. For example, bona fide, affidavit, alibi. It is, you cannot pronounce it as A-L-I-B-I. You cannot pronounce it as alibi. It is alibi. So how you will find out nearly 350 languages, from 350 languages, words are borrowed. And particularly English words of Indian origin. Now, what about the simple we call in Tamil curry? And in English, it is called C-U-R-R-Y, curry. Okay. Then pandal. We call it pandal. And similarly, the word is there. Spelling P-A-N-D-A-L. And what we call in Tamil, kattumaram. And in English, catamaran. C-A-T-A-M-A-R-A-N. Then, bamboo. You all know, we also call it as bamboo. Okay, and if you find, if you read English literature students, if you read R.K. Narayan's novels, you will find out R.K. Narayan has used many words. Especially in almost all the novels, you will come across the word payol, P-Y-O-L. And it means actually, what we call in Tamil as, we call as thinnai. In those days, the house, every house will have a thinnai. So he calls it as payol, P-Y-O-L. So in this manner, you can engage the students for nearly even 1 hour or 2 hours. Then root words. Okay, what are root words? Ask them to go through, I will not ask them to go through the dictionary. They will find it difficult. All of them have got cells, mobiles. Go through Google. Google will tell you everything. You have seen that, those two words, ask anything. So you can ask anything. So why do you, you see, I won't say, something bad, you see bad things, I won't say that. But concentrate everything on something good. For example, root. It is actually a basic word. Root words are nothing but basic words. When you add prefix or suffix, then what happens? They change. For example, astro. You can change it as astronaut or astronomy or astrophysics. Okay. Similarly, magni. You can change it by adding fi, magnifying. Okay. And then even prepositions. Just one word, but by changing the preposition, what happens? The entire meaning changes. That is the beauty of the English language. I'll just give an example, you will understand. To laugh at a person and to laugh with a person. In both the sentence, we actually use the word laugh. I'll repeat, to laugh at a person or to laugh with a person. What is the meaning? What is the difference? Both are same? No, both are not same. There are a lot of differences. To laugh at a person meaning you are actually making fun of a person. Is it good? It is not. But when you are laughing with a person, you are sharing the joke with everyone and everybody has got everybody has a hearty laugh. That is something good. When all of you join and laugh at a person, what happens? That person will be offended. So merely, a small change of preposition. That is the beauty of the English language. Okay. And then We'll go to the next slide. I mean, these are all how you can engage the students, how the students can learn. Not necessarily, I mean, the teacher has to be there, but I mean, the students can actually do all these things. Now, a teacher can actually introduce a current topic. See, every day, actually, you will find in television breaking news. Once in 5 minutes, you will find breaking news. And what is that? I mean, breaking news today or yesterday, it is about the, you will find it is about the climate. In next 42, 48 hours, once again, you will have heavy rains. And Chennai is going to suffer a lot. North Tamil Nadu, let me say, Vada Tamil Nadu, they will say. And you will wonder, what is Vada Tamil Nadu? Please check, Vada Tamil Nadu is nothing but Chennai. You are able to understand. We do not understand all these things. But once you check in Google, you will understand. Okay. And then class can be divided into two. Okay. And the teacher has to distribute the keywords. For example, when we are going to talk about the climate. Okay. Low pressure. Okay. Heavy rains. So what are all the things happened? I mean, in the last 10 days, everything you can talk about. Everything. I mean, everything under the sun you can talk about. Okay. Then grammatical errors can be ignored. So the teacher or the students, you need not bother about the grammatical errors. Okay. Grammar, because if you find this is whether I can talk like this, is it? I mean, whether I will commit grammatical mistake, then the flow will stop. So that is why I'm asking you, don't worry about grammatical errors. In course of time, you will know how to avoid grammatical errors. You yourself will identify. Okay, now you don't worry. Initially, you don't worry at all. Just proceed. Okay, what is important is your guts to talk in an open forum. That is what important. Okay, that is what, I mean, how to promote a discussion. Okay, right. I see if I commit a mistake in front of my friends, students will laugh at me. Never think like that. And you cannot speak in English at all. Never think like that. Okay. We'll go to the next slide. Narrating stories and anecdotes and all these things also will help you to develop your, a talking skill, everything. Let it be a short one. If it is a story, you can tell stories. Why not? You can tell stories of animals. Okay, you can tell stories. I mean, our country actually, Panchatantra stories, they are very famous. You can talk about that. And when you tell stories, modulation in your voice should be there. What do you mean by modulation? Yetra irakkangal. Okay, you have to tell in a very convincing manner. So meet the eyes of the listeners. Don't look somewhere just because you are shy. Just meet the eyes of the listeners and you will feel. Please keep your body language properly. What do you mean by body language? I mean, don't stand erect. Don't be nervous. And when you meet the eyes of the listeners, you will know what kind of reaction they have. So that is why I'm asking you to meet the eyes of the listeners and let there be coherence. Okay, continuity. Okay, for example, anecdotes. What are anecdotes? Okay, stories we have seen. What about anecdotes? Small, short incidents. For example, when you come from home to the college, you must have seen many things. Do you see many things? Yes, of course, we see many things. But we are not paying attention. But if we pay attention, we will see many things. Okay, see, there is actually a saying, the seeing see little. The seeing means actually who people who have got the capacity of seeing, they see little. Little meaning here, nothing. Okay. So actually we people, all of us have been provided eyes and we can see everything, what is going on around us. But we simply choose to ignore everything. And we don't actually watch. You have to watch. You have to observe. For example, you are talking about an accident. Okay. You have to say, accident happened. I became nervous and ambulance came and then I rushed to college. I mean, where is the coherence? Where is the continuity? What kind of accident it was? Whose mistake it was? Then what happened? How the people helped the victim? Okay, and whether it was a mild one or a bigger one, and who was called, the police came immediately to the to rescue all these things. Then I became nervous. I was standing there for some time, and I observed everything you have to say. Then only there will be coherence. Okay, that is what I mean by coherence, continuity. Then only by your continuity only you can actually arrest the audience, capture the attention of the audience. Now we'll go to the next one. Now, definitely boys will be interested in games. Okay, now why don't you talk about games? Now, do you think only now at present, cricket is only going on? Do you think you have to talk about only cricket? Okay, if you are interested in cricket, tell your friend. Okay, tell your friend how to play cricket. Not all the boys or all the girls are good at playing cricket. Some may not know about that. Tell them how to play cricket. Okay. And what about the other games? Just find out the origin in Google. Find out the origin of these plays. For example, hockey and ice hockey. Where they are exactly born? In Canada. Then football, Britain. Then baseball and basketball, America. Then, you have to talk about cricket. And then cricket, where is the origin? England. Okay. Now, what about the traditional games of India? See, when you talk about all these things, you shouldn't forget about India because you are an Indian. What are the traditional games? You know very well. Kabaddi, Koko, and children will play with marbles. You must have seen. And Gilli, you must have known about it. Spinning top. And then, the ladies at home, they will play a board game called in Tamil as Dayam. Okay. And this actually played a vital role in Mahabharata. See, immediately you have to connect like that. Then only you will understand. You have to make the connection. Okay. And then even girls will play Pallanguri. You must have seen all those things. If you actually type it in Google, immediately the photo will come. The photo will come and the pronunciation will come. What more do you need? You can talk about it. You can discuss it in your next class. Okay. And then we'll see the next slide. Then why don't you talk about all these things? This is all. All these things are going on around you. Reasons. What are the reasons for celebrating Diwali, Pongal? Pongal, actually, you have to, you show your gratitude to the farmers, to the sun god. And Diwali, there are many stories. For example, some people will say it is the arrival of Lord Rama and Lakshman and Sita to the, arrival to Ayodhya. And some say it is actually we are celebrating the death of Narakasura. Different kinds of festivals. Okay, different kinds of reasons. There is no harm in that. Learn about everything. And then importance of Thiruvannamalai, just 2 or 3 days before. What is the importance of Thiruvannamalai? Many, even foreigners, Thiruvannamalai attracts many foreigners. Many tourists come from abroad to see this. Actually, you will find how large Shiva is one of the five elements, fire. He is in the form of fire in Thiruvannamalai. And who is the presiding deity of Sabarimala? You have to know about the other state also, Lord Ayyappa. Then importance of Varanasi. It is where the holy Ganges, it is in Uttar Pradesh. When you come across these words, immediately know about all these things. And it is also called the Benares. Okay, when you have a holy dip in the Ganges, it is, especially elders will say, you will attain a lot of punyam. Okay. And Chamundeshwari temple is actually in Mysore, Chamundeshwari hills. A very, very famous. So just find out all the states and what is famous in that state, not necessarily temple. You can even see shopping. What are all the things available? So whatever interests you, okay, just find out everything. Then in the next class, you discuss everything. Now we'll see the next slide. Then further activities. Okay, you can discuss movies also. Why not? You can discuss movies. Okay, now nowadays movies, they create a lot of controversy. Okay, you can talk about controversies also, but never be, don't indulge yourself in too much of political things, but indulge in controversies, doesn't matter. Then climate, prevailing in countries, especially in India, especially in Tamil Nadu. Now, I'm just asking you, you must have listened and you must have seen in television, Vali Mandala Meladukku Suvarchi. What is that in English? Find out. Okay, you come across these words, you meet these words every now and then, just find out. And then maps, see the map. Okay, so even in India map, where exactly Chennai and where exactly the pressure. Okay, they have shown it in TV. You just find out. In Google, you find out how it moves. They will say, now it is 160 kilometers away from Tamil Nadu, then 100 kilometers. Then you just trace everything. Okay, that will be interesting. Then there are many topics like transportation. Okay, transportation important. I mean, important is the rise in the price of petrol. And that is actually the boys and men will talk about it a lot, how it is going on increasing and talk about all these things. And only one thing I'll tell you, what is going on around you? Okay, actually what I said, the seeing see little, nowadays you have to see a lot what is going on around you. Now, I have given a few things, a few activities, and these things actually help you to think, to remember, to reason, to read, to pay attention, to justify, to learn, and to understand. Now, all these things are what? Cognitive skills. Now, you understand? When you do all these things, there will be cognitive development in you, and you will become a holistic person. Thank you.
I quote, one language set you in a corridor for life. Two languages open every door along the way. I unquote. Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable words. Now I request Keetna from the Department of Biotechnology to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all gathered here. On this wonderful morning, it gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks. We take this golden opportunity to thank the respected chief guest who made this function a grand success, Dr. R. Revati, Dean of Sri Krishnaswamy College for Women, Ananahar, who honored this function with her inspirational thoughts. We will cultivate the ideas and advice you gave us in real life, ma'am. I am so thankful for everything you bring to our mind. I extend my gratitude to the Honorable Chairman, Dr. K. Vasudevan, sir, who permitted us to conduct this program for the welfare of students. Our Vice Chairman, Engineer V. Prasanna Venkatesh, sir, who arranged this program and motivated us. And also, my sincere thanks to our beloved principal, Dr. M. Uma, ma'am, who encouraged and always stand behind us for our development in both academics as well as extracurricular activities. I also thank the IIC coordinators for arranging such a motivated and knowledgeable seminar. I am so grateful for the staff members and participants, last but not least, our beloved students for making this function a grand success. I once again thank one and all present here.
Students, please fill the feedback form. BCom students will receive the feedback form through your HOD.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the opportunity. I think, I mean, it is, I mean, the students are able to enjoy, I believe.
Yes, ma'am. It was very simple and I think students should have really enjoyed. It should have reached the message what you wanted to convey should have reached them, ma'am.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, madam.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you for the wonderful presentation, ma'am. It was really
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you.
Now I request everyone to raise for the national anthem.
Ma'am, I'll play the national anthem.
Yes, sir.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hai Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Uttara Vandha Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jalabhi Taranda Tava Shubha Name Jage Tava Shubha Ashish Mage Gahe Tava Jaya Gatha Jana Gana Mangala Gayaka Jaya He Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Jai Hind, Jai Hind, Jai Hind, Jai 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 Hind.
Thank you, everyone. Have a pleasant day.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
We'll meet sometime later, ma'am.
Sure. Thank you. You also come to our college one day.
Yeah, ma'am. Please. Sure.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Advice, ma'am.
Thank you. Shall I leave, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
I'm Subhashi, ma'am. I'm ending the session, ma'am.